hydrogen fuel cell and hydrogen gas turbine. The future for alternative propulsion for air transportation is clearly not based exclusively on 100% electric solution, at least not at this point. Within Energia program, Embraer is developing its first hydrogen-powered airplane using fuel cell, the E982FC, which will be introduced by 2035. The concept is expected to have an electric propulsion, but powered by hydrogen through a fuel cell, which generated energy would be stored on batteries. The fuel cell is being designed and tested specifically for this aircraft. It brings its challenge since this technology has its own complexity and doesn't represent too much weight reduction. This is the first hydrogen variation adapted from the new turboprop that Embraer is developing and working to have its business case finished by the end of this year and approved by the beginning of the next year. Few modifications will be made in order to give the turboprop a hydrogen variation, as hydrogen is best stored in cylindrical containers rather than square ones. The fuel tanks in the wings will be removed, and the rear section of the airplane will give way to hydrogen cylinders, while sleeker, cleaner and more aerodynamic wings will be used. Elevators and propellers will be changed as well by designs with better aerodynamics. The E982FC would be able to fly about 200 nautical miles, carrying up to 19 passengers plus crew, with a noise reduction around 70% lower than today's standards. This airplane will also be used as platform for another type of hydrogen system, and this variation is the E5082GT, a hydrogen and gas turbine airplane. This concept doesn't require fuel cell and an electric engine. Instead, the model will use a modified turbine capable of burning either sustainable aviation fuel or jet A and hydrogen. Such kind of technology will allow the aircraft to fly a longer distance, carrying more passengers than the E982FC. The fuel burn management will dedicate 100% hydrogen burn through typical routes, while SAF and jet A would be used exclusively as reserve and range extender. So, this variant would be capable of carrying up to 50 passengers through a distance of 500 nautical miles. When not using SAF or jet A, which will be most of the time, CO2 emission will be zero, and standard noise is expected to be 60% lower than standards. It's clear that all vehicles presented here within alternative propulsion variants will be dedicated to short-haul operators. The E9FE might even attend general aviation airplanes owners. However, these are the first steps for a cleaner, efficient, and accessible air transportation for passengers. The airspace industry is doing its homework, and we might expect broader developments and better capabilities in the course of the time, such like we have seen on the automotive industry. As a good market maker, Embraer is working to diversify its portfolio to guarantee a long-lasting future by bringing new technologies, adhering to changes in the freight market, presenting alternatives and offering its solution to disrupt urban air transportation. There are more undertakings on the development of military technologies, such as drones and further surveillance solutions, that might add to the company's wealth, but we are not mentioning them in this video. Despite problems with a partnership which crumbled before it be sealed, the company is doing great on its own, showing vision, power to execute and resilience, as it has done since the beginning. If you make it this far, please give it a like, it's important for the channel, and consider subscribing. I hope that you enjoyed the video, and see you soon.